Right now we're in Cape Town, South Africa. This is Cape Town, South Africa, the shopping center. You know? I'm taking my friend Tebe to shop to buy some food. I just arrived, settling in so we could go on the adventure. But this is what South Africa looked like. Yeah, oil, right? I'll meet you around. So this is it, South Africa, Cape Town. Yeah, the people with money are in the supermarket. Yo, Jamaicans, let me tell you something, Jamaicans. When I tell you, Jamaicans, let me tell you something. Boy, I'm not telling you. No sewer gone. I'm not for telling you. No sewer gone. I'm not for telling you. Sewer gone. I'm not for telling you. Sewer gone. No sewer gone. So this is 80 cents.
80 rands.
Yeah. So.
Yes, like 80 cents.
And so I'm gonna get some water to drink. Like 80 cents for this bottle, so the water is cheaper than America. Getting some food for the place I'm staying. My brother Tebe is a big time musician. You're gonna see his videos after these interview. So this is South Africa. Basically, the water is not that expensive. The food is not that expensive, you know? So the place I'm staying, I could, then I'm gonna get me some rum, get some alcohol, get some eggs, make some cooking out of mine. You don't wanna waste money going out all the time, you know? Get some fruits and some things, some bananas. Alright? So yeah, I saw it look, I saw it set up. Table, where have I set to the people? Oil. So. Yeah. Some alcohol. Yeah, I'm gonna get some wine for the place. I'm fully, but hey, you're Jamaicans, you know what I'm saying to you. Don't let nobody tell you nothing about Africa. You need to come to see for yourself. All right? This side of the world? Different. All right, I'm going to link off. I'll link you back. Guys, this is South Africa. A lot of people in the States don't understand
what's
going on down here.
Yeah? I don't think you have them in the States. Even the guys who put petrol in your car, all the lowest jobs you can ever think of. In the new black country, we still servants.
Let me look at this. This is going to the supermarket in South Africa, and this is the mall in South Africa. That's Tebe. This is the gangster right there. This guy is a big time musician. Traveled the world. And we're gonna now get the car. This is our cart guy. He's responsible for helping us to bring the food from the supermarket. Now, this is going all over the world. Tell the people in the world how you love South Africa.
Oh, I love South Africa very well. Because I was born here, everything else, I know what everything was happening here.
Yeah?
Yes, yes.
What do you know about Jamaica?
Jamaica, I didn't make it to Jamaica, so I didn't went there.
You listen to reggae music?
Yes.
Yeah?
They say reggae music.
Is Jamaica big in South Africa? Jamaicans?
Yeah, Jamaica is a city. I like to Rasta music, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah. I was bringing the Berlin Spear also.
Berlin Spear?
Yes.
They're amazing,
in
right?
Kalsha, yes.
So that's the gangster Teba right there. You know, the rude boy. Just going through. Oh, there's our car. We're living in South Africa. We'll buy some things for the place and things. And this culture is something interesting going on down here. Very, very interesting going on down here in this country right now. And we're going to talk about it later.
But we respect him, we love him, but they can't be brutally. They can't Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe, the father of Pan-Africanism. So there's whatever unfinished, unhealing, see? We, our first black president made us to insist down the fire. You see, because no future is fixed and the situation, we really look at black people on the street, man. So we need real economical justice. Serious thing, but channel.
South Africa did it. Yes. South Africa. Business, commerce, separation. Yeah. Financial separation.
Yeah, man. Economical segregation and spiritual brainwash. Because none of me people, when they see God, they see the slave master, who not look like them. So that is a serious thing that so Rasta and some of the Kushites and Kamatik and traditionalists, them look upon a black messiah and creator who create we like him. She or him is like we, not like the slave master. That is the biggest thing. No, enough people, they want to relate to their spirituality, because if you are spiritually confused and brainwash, you can't expect to be political and economically relevant. So it's a serious thing. They might demonize black spirituality. They might talk about we not have history. They talk about we savages and uncivilized. But this mere city, beautiful city, is made from black people.
And the black people sleeping on the ground there.
Those people, enough of them used to be farm workers.
Yeah.
They used to pay them with alcohol.
So they paid the farm workers with alcohol?
Yeah, it's called the dope system. If you go to Google, called dope system, where they used to pay them with alcohol after. And enough of them is the original natives of this region called the Western Cape.
So they were the original warriors.
Yeah, them.
So they paid them with alcohol to drunk them forever.
Yeah, you see them, they've got the same status like the Aboriginal. They are classified as flora and fauna.
Mm-hmm.
You see, and them is one of the landless people. But you see, the my tribe, my name is a fusion of the natives and the Ngunis from Kush, Ethiopia, coming down Africa. Mm-hmm. I'm that breed. But the original is when we go towards Johannesburg, mm-hmm. we're gonna go to the cradle of the humankind, the first Homo sapiens. Mm-hmm. The natives of this region are the original human beings in the world. You see the Eskimo, the Japanese, and all the human DNA, it goes back to what they call them, the Bushman, mm-hmm. or the Khoisan, or the Hottentots, and the Greeker. Mm-hmm. You're gonna go through all these different segregations, but my bloodline is the warriors, the Zulu warriors, the Nguni, the Zimbabweans, the Yoruba, Nixians, Shanti, and Kushites. We hail strongly from the east, from Ethiopia, but our spirituality and history tell us, even my mother is what we call in another Sotho language or Setswana, we call them Barwa. Barwa is the original Bushman. Mm-hmm. So it's a long story because we didn't get the Malay-Asian slaves that became dominant in this region, classified under the term colored, right? As black, British, white, but in between. Mm-hmm. And like in prison, if they give a black man a dry bread, they want to give a so-called colored a bread with some gem. This is a Rasta capital. Rasta man, vibration. Yeah, man, blessed. So this is Rasta capital in the whole country. You see, extra Monta Rasta man. And they will keep it natural and urban.
Civic center, see this, performance this, and stuff happens here.
That's where we're going. The civic center is just municipality office. Where we're going now is the theater, the big theater. See this area over here, so used to be water. The water used to go as far as the castle. I'm going to show you the castle. So this is called the foreshore. From this area onwards is the harbor. Behind this building is the harbor, is the waterfront. We're going to take you there. So going right through, this used to be the old beach front line. And there is one suburb called Pardon Island. It used to be an island. So this is some Dutch engineering. Because the Dutch, they live below sea level. It's Bishop Tutu and those in the river. Himself.
No, he's drinking the water.
You see, because there's also like a lot of crack fiends in this area.
Okay.
People doping themselves. This is the artscape. The legend.
The artscape.
Yes, sir.
How did you become a part of this artscape?
They once had some auditions. Uh-huh. And then they ask, how would you write a hip-hop story for a family and intellectuals and just even for the heads themselves? I told them how I would write it, and they called me. They said they liked my presentation, and it was history.
Good.